Good morning, Rabotai. Continuing with some of the halachot of Slichot, it happens sometimes that a person cannot make a minyan for Slichot, although there are many morning, afternoons, chatzot. Let's say a person's in a place or in a situation where he cannot make a minyan for Slichot. The halacha is that Slichot may be recited b'chidut. It is mutar. Most of it is only Slichot v'tachanunim. However, there are certain things that have to either be tweaked or omitted. For instance, anything in, let's start the other way around. First of all, the most important part of Slichot, the primary part of the Slichot, is the five Vayavor and Yud Gimel Midot. That is, by far, the most important part of Slichot. The Gemara says in Masechet Rosh Hashanah that any time a Tzibur comes together and says the Yud Gimel Midot, HaKadosh Baruch Hu forgives them when they say Bechavana. So, nevertheless, this is considered something, it's considered a Davar Shel Kiddusha, Yud Gimel Midot, you need a Minyan for. However, so that says the Shulchan Aruch based on Shuvat HaRashba, you have to skip without a minyan. Unless you're able to read it kekore b'Torah. Unless you're reading it like you read from the Torah, which means you're allowed to read, it's psukim from the Torah, Parashat Kitisa. You read it with the proper te'amim, you can say it as follows. You can say it like that, that's fine. If you don't know the te'amim, you have to skip it, because otherwise it requires a minyan. In a minyan, Yud Gimel Midot Hashem Hashem, you don't have to say it with te'amim. You know the te'amim, you can say it. Bechidut. Only with ta'amim, if not you have to omit. Then you have the Aramaic portions. There are several Aramaic portions of the Slichot. Usually, by the way, the way to differentiate between Lashon HaKodesh and Aramaic, most Aramaic words, many of them, end with an Aleph. Rachamana, all, you know, things of that nature. So Shezvana, all these things end with an Aleph. So all those Rachamana, Machomaseh, all these portions of the Slichot without a minyan, since the Malachei HaSharet do not understand Aramaic, they don't appreciate when being spoken to in general in a language that they don't understand, so they will not bring up those prayers to the Kisei HaKavod. In a minyan, however, you don't need the assistance of the Malachei HaSharet to raise up the tefillot. The tefillot of a tzibur go up directly to Kisei HaKavod, and therefore, you can say even the Aramaic portions, there are several poskim that say that even the Aramaic portions that are usual in the Slichot, you can say, ve'en alacha kmotam. The halacha does not follow this opinion. A person must be chidut, skip the Aramaic portions. What happens if a person's in a minyan shel Slichot, and he's not reading exactly with the chazan? He's a little bit ahead, a little bit behind, whatever it is. Can he read over there? Is that considered bitzibur, such that he's able to read the Aramaic portions? The answer to that is yes. As long as a person, pachot yoter, is praying along with the tzibur, he's in the presence of a minyan, he's allowed to say even the Aramaic portions of the Slichot Yom Tov Mevorach.